probably about 14.
A couple of hundred. My first gig was 1979, 34 years to the day today.
How many times have you seen the dam?
128 today.
How many times have you been to the dam?
900 tonight. 36. This is 36.
This is my 49th gig.
Where was the first time you saw him?
Oxford in 1983, 4, something like that.
And out of all the times you've seen them, which one was your favourite? Or when were they best?
Yesterday.
Second time I've seen the dam.
When was the first?
2 years ago, yeah.
That's taking you a long time. So how many times have you seen the dam?
I can't remember, but tonight is the 30th anniversary of the first time I saw them at the Rainbow in 1979.
Happy anniversary, sir.
Well, thank you very much.
Okay, tell me who you are and where we are.
Okay, well, this is my home, and as you see here, a nice little band, and who am I? I'm not quite sure. I've been trying to figure out who I am. I'm an oxymoron. I'm a contradiction in terms. I'm a strange voyager from another galaxy, but I found myself in the wrong universe, and everything's upside down and wrong way up, and I'm travelling through life backwards, and here I am.
That was actually my next question. How did you get here? How did you get to be playing with the dam from where you started? Where did you start?
Where did I start? I started in Cambridge. I was born in Cambridge, and so that's where I started.
Yeah.
And then there's a bit of a gap, and other things happened. And then suddenly I was in the dam, because I met Captain in Brighton, and we played together with Dr. Space Toad and other strange people. And
Was it an easy way in? Did they just say, we want you? Or was it a long process?
Well, it was a detour. I had to become a nurse first. I had to become a psychiatric nurse first.
Is that the deal to get into damned?
Well, I don't know. I think part of the deal to get in the dam as a keyboard player is that you have to have a mother who's a Jehovah's Witness, because this is what I have in common with Dave Greenfield of the Stranglers, who has a mother who had a mother, I don't know if she's still alive, bless her, who is a Jehovah's Witness, and they're just two keyboard players in famous punk bands, and we both have mothers who are Jehovah's Witnesses.
That is how you get into the jam, any aspirational musicians. Yeah. But my next question was, why do you always wear purple? Not criticising you, I think it's great,
I don't really know. I'm not quite sure. I mean, it's just sort of a colour I've fallen into. As I say, maybe I'll have a green period next. I'm not quite sure. You know, like the Picasso thing. You might go through purple. This might be a purple period. Our friend Dr. Space Toad, again, he did a song called I'm Trapped in a Purple Moon.
How did you gel in with the dam when you first joined?
Oh, it was fine. It was really good. I just kind of fell into. I mean, I was already a fan, so I knew the songs in my head. So I just had to.
What was the first song that you got involved in with them that you just remember thinking, this one's awesome?
Oh right, well it's probably Curtain Call. We did that from the start. We did a version of Curtain. It probably wasn't a great version to begin with. We had this really crappy keyboards that I borrowed. Borrowed from Roy in the Space Turning Experience, and then Captain had a little module, and I was playing around with that. But yeah, it was really nice to do that song. Always loved that song.
Since you joined in, not after the original lineup, which member was your favourite? No one's around, so it's okay. You can say.
Oh gosh, can I say? Well, I suppose I've. Difficult to say. I owe everything to the captain. I owe everything to Captain.
It's sensible.
I wouldn't be doing this if it wasn't for him. And we shared so much musical interest, like Sid Barrett and Soft Machine and Messiaen and Terry Riley and all sorts of things. So you know, I think I'd have to say the captain.
What's Captain like after a show, or is there a side to Captain that we don't see?
Well, there are many sides to catch. Many sides that he wouldn't see. Yeah.
Do go on.
Oh, God, I can't really, you know, I can't think specifically, but he's a very sophisticated person. I mean, people wouldn't know that. You think, he's a jokey fella. That's part of it, definitely. But he's very intelligent. He's quite a deep person. In a lot of ways.
Did you ever know Rat?
No, I've never met him. In all the years I've been in the band, I've never met Rat at all.
Did they ever speak about Rat around you?
Well, I've heard plenty about him. So, not always good, especially from the captain.
a human being who does other stuff, what do you do in your spare time?
With spare time, it depends. Well, when I'm working, well, I need to work sometimes. So I'm a psychiatric nurse. I did that, and I still work for Anchor Trust. I work for, and I work for the elderly, so mostly people with dementia. And the rest of the time, I'm sort of reading philosophy and looking at a lot of classical music on YouTube, because everything's on YouTube.
Yeah. Captain on Stage did say, everyone give kudos to Monty. He's a genius. What is he doing in the Damned? And I've heard a lot about you and all your achievements, but I know that I will never be able to get that information out of you. And it makes you nervous, just the thought of having to speak about it, I'm guessing.
What is it you desire?
what are your achievements? How did you start off in music? Yeah.
Oh, right. Well, I completely, totally and utterly failed to learn to read music for a start. I'm musically dyslexic. You know, my level of reading music is like C-A-T, so it's capita, so it's E-F, oh, that's a G, isn't it? You know, it's like that.
Yeah.
So I can't read it. I wish I could, but I can't.
Do you,
it's all
can you
by
still
ear.
Not read today?
No, I still can't read today.
So you just do it all off?
It's all by ear and improvise. I've always been into improvisation since an early age. My grandmother played for silent movies.
Yeah.
So she'd have to look and see what they want and come up with tunes. I mean, some of them, I think they had some set tunes on the suspense bit and this bit and that. But there was a fair amount of improvisation involved. And that was what interested me. She did this thing and she went, that's a bubbling brook. I thought, ah, I like that. I want to do stuff like that.
I saw a bit of that tonight, actually. I was pretty impressed because every single move you did, everyone thought you were just going crazy, but I saw that you were hitting like every single note.
Right, and I know the song, you know, I know the songs pretty well, but also into, you know, I like, you know, I suppose dance is very close to music with the parts of the brain you're
definitely
using. There are different parts of the brain you're using, obviously the motor parts, but I think the cerebellum of that
yeah
is a very important part for movement, for fine movements anyway, and that sort of ties in, and I've heard it's supposedly tied in with emotion and stuff as well, so there's a sort of feeling thing about it, but the feeling and the sound,
yeah,
it all comes together.
It's kind of strange, like a stormy sea. I don't know why, I don't know why. I guess these things have gotta be. I've got a new rose, I've got a good. Guess I knew that I always would. I can't stop to mess around. I got a brand new rose in town. See the sun, it shines. Don't get too close or it'll burn your eyes.